fight. It's either fight or flight. Anybody know what that means? Either
fight
you have
or
that's the only question for you. Only decision you have is either you're going to fight or you're going to run. That's right. If something is so hard in front of you, you're going to fight or you're going to run away. That's the only two decisions you have when it really comes down to it. Alright? So, when this happened, I would, and wrestling they teach you, never, ever, ever give up. No matter what the case may be, never give up. And people say, well, what if you're down by 15 points and there's 10 seconds left? What are the odds of you winning? You just don't give up. You don't give up. You're fighting for the next match. You're fighting for what's inside of you. You know? And when, and so how I got through this is that, you know, there's a part in the book where I was trying to train a baseball team, and the only thing I cared about was whether they could look straight forward, right? And I told everyone to stand on a straight line, and the only thing I want you to do is to line up in a straight line, look forward, don't look left, don't look right, and don't look back, and walk around the gym. Some people couldn't do it. Some people are like, I'm going to look this way, I'm going to look that way, I'm going to look here. I said, listen, you want to be on the team, all I need you to do is look forward. So what I started doing, to make a long story short, is that I eliminated everything that was going to get in my way of fighting. Okay? Blame. Feeling sorry for myself. Okay? Basically saying it's impossible. That's looking left. That's looking right. That's looking back. That is looking forward. So forward is how do I improve her? That's the only thing I'm concentrating on. So every single day, all I thought about is how do I improve her just a little bit more. And I have a choice. I can either fight or I can leave.